In this video, I'm going to find a 95% confidence interval for P, the true population proportion. Minitab Express has only three default settings for our level of confidence, 90, 95, and 99%. So if you need to find any other level of confidence, you're going to either need to find your confidence interval by hand using the formula, or your TI-84, which I did in my previous video, or some other statistical software package. In this problem, we have a survey of 4,015 U.S. adults between age of 18 and 29. 1,445 of those said they have at least one tattoo. So again, I'm going to use Minitab Express to find the 95% confidence interval. I need to click on my statistics tab and go down to one sample and go down to proportion. And I don't have the data in a column. That would be, for example, a series of zeros and ones. One would indicate that they do have at least one tattoo, and a zero would be no tattoos. For the problems you encounter in your homework, if you're taking my class, you're going to always have the summarized data. So you want to use this little down arrow, click on summarized data. The number of events indicates the number of observations or number of successes, I'm sorry. So 1,445 that they had at least one tattoo. And number of trials, that will be the total number of observations, or your sample size, and that's 4,015. Now, if you click on OK right here, Minitab Express defaults to a 95% confidence interval for P. And also notice in the output, it's not using the normal approximation to the binomial method that is shown in our textbook. So we want to change that. We want to change our, we do want a 95% confidence interval. I was thinking we wanted a 90%, but we do want a 95%, but we do need to change this method to match the method that's presented in our section. So I want to click on Make Similar, and I want to go to Options. And if I wanted to, I could change my level of confidence. Again, Minitab Express only has three. And instead of exact for your method, you want to select normal approximation. And then you'll see the confidence interval endpoints are the same as the endpoints that I got in my previous video when I used the TI-84. To find the confidence interval for P.